Welcome back to PipingStress.net. Today, we're diving into a topic that's crucial for anyone looking to build a career in the engineering field, specifically, how to start your journey as a piping stress engineer. Whether you're a student, a recent graduate, or someone looking to pivot into this specialization, I've got you covered. First, what exactly does a piping stress engineer do? In simple terms, your job is to make sure that piping systems in industrial plants, like oil and gas facilities, power plants, and chemical factories, can handle all the stresses they face during operation. We're talking about pressure, temperature, seismic activity, wind, and even the weight of the pipes themselves. It's a role that's all about safety and reliability. So, how do you get started? A bachelor's degree in mechanical engineering is typically the first step. Some people also come from civil, structural, or chemical engineering backgrounds, and that's okay too. If you're really serious about specializing, you might consider going for a master's degree, but that's not always necessary. Next, let's talk about the skills you'll need. First and foremost, you need a solid understanding of engineering fundamentals, mechanics, material science, and fluid dynamics. You'll also need to get comfortable with stress analysis, things like thermal expansion, vibration, and fatigue. And don't forget about software. Tools like Caesar 2, AutoPipe, and Roar 2 are your bread and butter. Now, let's dive into the codes and standards you'll need to know. The big ones are ASME B31.3 for process piping and ASME B31.1 for power piping. If you're dealing with storage tanks, API 650 is key. And for managing vibration, check out NEMA SN23. Depending on where you're working, you might also need to know European standards like EN 13480 or ISO 14692 for non-metallic piping. Okay, so you've got the education and the skills. Now, start with internships or co-op programs to get some hands-on experience. Look for entry-level roles as a junior piping engineer or in related fields like structural engineering. And don't underestimate the value of a good mentor, they can guide you and help you grow. Field experience is also golden. If you can, get out there and see how these systems are installed and operated in the real world. By the way, you can find useful information and documents on various topics by visiting our site, pipingstress.net, and our YouTube channel. The learning doesn't stop once you land your first job. Consider getting certifications like a professional engineer license, and attend workshops and seminars to stay up to date. Joining professional organizations like ASME can also be a great way to network and learn. Now, let's talk about some of the challenges you might face. The calculations can be complex, and you'll need to balance safety with cost-effectiveness. Strong communication skills are also important. You'll be working with a lot of different people, from other engineers to project managers to clients. As you gain experience, you might choose to specialize in areas like seismic or dynamic analysis. And with time, you could move into leadership roles or even consulting. So, there you have it, your roadmap to becoming a piping stress engineer. It's a challenging but incredibly rewarding career. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so you never miss an update. And if you have any questions or topics you'd like me to cover in future videos, drop them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, see you in the next one.